If you export your model and find that the texture is really blurry or low quality, you should first check and see if your generated texture atlas is the culprit. Before opening the texture atlas, you can even check the quality comparison by hitting T on your keyboard to switch between the model image generated from the texture atlas and the image generated from the original PSD. Just as an aside, remember that you can also go under Show Display Quality to change the render quality of viewing your model in Live2D if you have a large model that is lagging on your PC while you rig. This display quality will not affect the final resolution of your model. To open your texture atlas, go to Modeling, Texture, Edit Texture Atlas. If you have items placed on the texture atlas but you want to start over, you can hit Ctrl A to select everything and then the Delete key to delete everything. If you were adding a new texture image for the first time, you can set your width and height. You will want to set the size of your texture atlas to what is most suited for your textures. Ideally, you will want to allow your largest pieces of art mesh to fit on one page without rescaling. For me, my largest textures are my leg and pants pieces, and those fit fine on a 4096 size. I would advise against going for texture sizes much larger than 4096 where possible, as it can cause performance issues. Unfortunately, if you're on the free version of Live2D Cubism, you're limited to one texture image at a maximum of 2048 pixels wide. Select all of your parts. I am going to click on the first one, and then I am going to shift click on the last one to select everything between. Right click, place selected objects to texture atlas. This is probably the source of your blurriness. If you have it set to set the scale automatically, it may scale down your images much smaller than their actual size. You are going to want to go to specify and you will set it to 100%. I also recommend increasing the margin size from the default, which is the space between adjacent art meshes. I haven't had issues at 15 pixels, but it will depend on the layout and your model. If your margin is too small, you can have small pieces of an art mesh overlapping the edge of another art mesh, which can create weird visual artifacts in your final model. Outside of Live2D, any programs reading your model will use the texture atlas to show your model art, so it is very important to make sure that you set it up correctly. On this model, I actually couldn't fit that many textures on the page at 100% scale, so we can go to Add Texture and add a second texture, so we'll have more pages of our texture atlas to place images on. This is a little bit of trial and error, and you will need to find out what will work for not only you, but also the specific model that you are working on. Some of the things that you need to place in your texture atlas may not need to be at 100% scale, and maybe you'd still have great quality if you put the scale down to something like 75%. Though I will say that when I do have to have multiple pages of a texture atlas, I like to group each page by similar parts. This could also be really helpful if you needed to downscale some of your textures, but wanted to make sure that you had full resolution of pieces like your eyes or your hair. Here, I added my hair, eyes, face, and mouth textures into one page that I set to 100%, but for these sparkles, a crisp resolution wasn't quite as necessary, so I put them all on one page and chose to set the scale automatically. When you are done and hit OK, it probably will take quite a bit of time to render out the texture atlas, so don't worry if it's taking a while and just be patient. You can continue making tweaks to the texture atlas until you are happy with the quality of everything. There is a lot more to know about texture atlases, but I know that when I was starting out, it took me a long time to realize the culprit of my low quality was automatic scale on my texture atlas. I hope this helps, and let me know if you have any questions about texture atlases or if there's anything else about Live2D that you'd like to learn.